So now we will see the factors on which time period depends. Okay. First we will see that on the effective length, time period is directly proportional to square root of its effective length, or we can say that is effective length is proportional to square of the time period. It means if the effective length increases, time period also increases. What does it mean? It means if we take a short string, okay, if the effective length of a string is very small, then we can easily assume that it will swing so fast. It means its frequency will be more because of its shorter length. So in that case, since it will swing fastly, so that's why time period is very small. It means it will just complete one oscillation in a very short period of time. Conversely, if we can say that if we make it large, if we increase the length, then it means there will be a huge load on this. Isn't it? Just like this. So in that case, it will just take so many times, that is a comparatively long time to complete a oscillation, because its frequency will be less. In that case, it cannot swing or oscillate so fast, that is frequency becomes less. It is just like put something, it means you are walking freely without any load or any luggage, and if a 20 kg or 30 kg load or luggage is generally put on your head, then what will be the effect? You can easily assume. So same things happens here. Clear? So increase in the effective length, increase the time period. Mind it one thing, that is increasing time period means it swings very slowly, because time period is the required time to complete one oscillation. Shorter length, it will swing so fast. Frequency more. Okay, it means it will, clear? It means shorter length, shorter time period, more frequency, so less time period. Less time period means time is the required time to complete one oscillation is very small. It means it can complete one swing in just 1 second or 2 seconds. But if we enlarge, increase the length, it means it will become a fat person, just like it will oscillate. It will take a longer time to complete one oscillation. Time period is more. Okay. In that case, time period is more, it means frequency is less. In that case, it cannot be able to complete so many oscillations. It will just complete less oscillations. I think it is very clear. More time period means delay. Less time period means fast. Clear? Because it is the matter of time. If we take the length, if we double the length, isn't it? If we take the 4 times of the length, the time period becomes double. Clear? Suppose if we take the length, okay, 4 times, then it will, the time period becomes twice. If we take the effective length 9 times, then time period becomes 3 times. Clear? So that is, it is square root. Clear? If we take the length 4, it will become the 2, that is twice, then it is thrice. So it means, remember one thing, time period is directly proportional to the square root of the effective length. Increase in effective length, increase in time period. Decrease in effective length, decrease in time period. Then time period is inversely proportional to the square root of the acceleration due to gravity. Clear? All these are experimentally observed values, because the total value of the time period is t is equal to 2 pi root over l by g. Time period is always constant. You can perform it in your home. If you make a simple pendulum, and if you take the time period for 20 oscillations, okay, then you can take the time period for 20 oscillations. You can take the time period for 40 oscillations. Then divided that oscillations by 40, you will get the required time period. For 40 oscillations, that is required time. For one oscillation, you will see that the time period is constant, because this is a single simple pendulum. So that's why its time period cannot be different. If you take 20 oscillations, to complete 20 oscillations, suppose the required time is 2 seconds. So time period is 2 by 20. So obviously, if 20 to complete 20 oscillations, it takes 2 seconds. So obviously, to complete 40 oscillations, it will take
4 seconds.
So 4 divided by 40 is equal to 110. So time period is always constant. Acceleration due to gravity, it is inversely proportional. It means if acceleration due to gravity increases, time period decreases, and if acceleration due to gravity decreases, it increases. Because acceleration due to gravity is not constant at all point. As you all know that the gravity means the force by which Earth attracts any object towards its center. It means the object which is very close to Earth, to the center of the Earth, it attracts with more attractive forces, and which is situated at a very far, it attracts with a lesser force. So the acceleration due to gravity on Earth is the maximum. As we gradually go in the upward direction, that is in the against gravity and towards the center of the gravity, that is from Earth's surface. If this is Earth's surface, above it and below it, acceleration due to gravity decreases. It means the acceleration due to gravity at the foot and at the top of the any mountain or the Himalaya is not same. At the foot it is higher or it is more, and at the top it is generally decreases, because acceleration due to gravity is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the object and the center of the Earth. As you when you will promote it to the higher class, you will study in detail. So from that relation we can found t is equal to 2 pi root over l by g. So calculating, we can get g is equal to 4 pi square l by t square. One thing, that is this time period doesn't depend on the mass of the bob. Clear? It doesn't depend on the mass of the bob. It only depends on the effective length and the acceleration due to gravity. More mass, clear? Lesser mass doesn't depend on the mass of the material of the bob. Clear? And okay, and it doesn't depend on the swing also. More fast, more swing, it doesn't depend. Clear? So from this, if we find out, we can see g is equal to 4 pi square l by t square. So if we plot a graph, if we plot the length along x-axis and the square of time along y-axis, we will see it will be a straight line passing through the origin. And if we take any point on the straight line and we draw the two perpendicular, one on length axis and one along t square axis, we will be able to see that l by t square is a constant. Okay, l by t square is always a, okay, the value of l by t square is a constant, and multiplying by g by 4 pi square, we will get that it is 9.8. clear? That is 9.8 meter per second square. Clear?